Hey guys, happy Valentine's Day, Kaylee here. So I thought I would share this testimony because it is so important, especially since today is all about love and relationships. Now, I'm gonna share this story. It might be a little sad, but bear with me, it's gonna get better at the end. I had a boyfriend for 8 years. His name was Michael. And Michael and my anniversary was Valentine's Day. 1 week ago today marks 4 years since Michael passed away. And right before he passed away, Michael reached out and we had a phone conversation, and I want to share that last conversation with you. Michael said, "Kaylee, I hit rock bottom. I need your help. You are my reason to live. You are my rock, and I cannot live without you." Now, how many times in relationships do we look to the person that we're with, our partner, our husband, our wife? Do we look to them as our savior? I could not save Michael. And it is so important to know this, because the world and movies is going to tell you that you have to find that one person to complete you. And once you find that right partner, that all your needs will be met and you can have all these expectations. But the truth is, we are human. We are going to fail one another. We cannot meet every single person's need. And there's only one person who can do that, and his name is Jesus Christ. Now, at the time, I was a Christian who had never studied her Bible. And if you don't study your Bible, you cannot let your roots go down deep into Christ. In other words, is you cannot have your beliefs be affirmed over and over again to renew your mind if you're not studying your Bible. And it's easy to get deceived and drift away from your faith in Christ if you don't study your Bible. So I was a Christian who didn't study her Bible, and at the time Satan had deceived me and I got drifted into the New Age movement. The New Age movement is basically believing that you're your own savior, that you are your own rock, that you are godlike, that you are connected to everything, the universe, that you can just attract all that you want because you are your own God, that you can heal yourself. And that is not the truth. So this conversation with Michael, I said back to him, "No, Michael, I'm not your rock. You are. You're your reason to live." And that's not the truth. Michael passed, and I had a lot of grief and a lot of trauma and guilt, because I felt like I couldn't help him. And I'm so thankful for Jesus Christ, because he has healed me so much from that passing, the 4 years ago, that phone conversation, and the loss of Michael in my life. There are many things that we can believe and many thoughts and opinions we can have in this world, but let me tell you something. This is the truth. Jesus is the Word made flesh. And Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life to God the Father. And there's no other way to God except through Him. We're supposed to be meditating on our Word day and night. That way we can stay armored and we can know the truth. Because once you know the truth shall set you free. I found healing from my guilt, from my grief, deliverance from my strongholds, my drug addictions, my 20 years of childhood sexual abuse, all this stuff in my life because of Jesus Christ and getting rooted in my faith. I want to read this. In Isaiah chapter 43, verse 11, I am the Lord, and besides me, there is no savior. Chapter 44, verse 8. Do not fear nor be afraid. Have I not told you from that time and declared it? You are my witnesses. Is there a God besides me? Indeed, there is no other rock. I know not one. Jesus is our only savior, our only rock, and the only one who can deliver us from the pits and the rock bottoms that we experience here in this life. When you go through a rock bottom, it is a great time that you have the opportunity to check your heart. what's coming out of your mouth, for out of the abundance of our heart, our mouth speaks. You get to really witness, where am I searching for someone to save me? Am I leaning into the Word of God? Do I have friends who are edifying me and helping me grow towards my faith in Christ? If not, you're going to fall, you're going to stumble. But if you cry out to Jesus, He will save you. Jesus came to save our souls, to take us to eternity with Him in heaven, and He has a plan for your life laid out. The only way you can walk through that plan is if you are rooted in your faith. Now, when we go through our traumas and our trials in this life, and we have experiences in life that we've never been healed from, which is layers and layers, so often we're just gonna be like searching for someone, save me, help me, heal me. But we can't do that. Once you know the truth shall set you free. If you're going through a hard time right now, if you're in a relationship with someone and you're searching for them to heal you, they cannot. Don't even put that burden on someone. But instead, cry out to Jesus. Jesus will reveal Himself. He will show you that He is the one true Savior. And if you need any encouragement, if you need any prayer, please reach out, because I'm always available for prayer and always happy to help you. And I just love you guys so, so very much. Happy Valentine's Day. Like and subscribe, and have a beautiful rest of your day. God bless.